पहले अपना शूट देखने सेटने कर लीजिए तो क्या बोलो लॉक तो करो यार अरे यार तो छोटा है स्पीकर पे डाला तूने ऑडियो
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the Indian Documentary Foundation and Good Pitch India, supported by Tata Trust, I welcome all of you. It's an absolute honor and a pleasure to have you all join us for the introduction of a unique forum, something I'm sure none of you all are acquainted with. What Good Pitch is and what it does will be unfolded in the next hour, and I hope you guys are as excited as we are. My name is Urmi Chandavaz and I am your MC, which is host to the second Indian edition of Good Pitch.
Thanks. Welcome, friends from the media industry. Thank you for my friends for being here and supporting us. Let me quote a definition from a very prominent filmmaker called Albert Maysles. He said, if you look up the word entertainment in the dictionary, it is first defined as diversion. But the second definition is engagement. And the second one, I think, is the best one. And I think we live in an age where both definitions are correct. Documentary audiences are sophisticated enough to hold two seemingly contradictory reactions to a film at the same time, being diverted and being engaged. And at the same time, being able to balance both at the same time. And that's why I think documentaries are so exciting in today's times, because it's a new, enhanced way to appreciate film. India, like we all know, is a vibrant nation whose strength lies in its commitment to equal rights to speech, religious, economic freedoms, and which enrich the lives of all citizens. India is not only the world's largest democracy, it's also a secular, pluralistic society committed to inclusive growth. Exceptions in the recent times hopefully will be corrected and overcome with your common sense and conscience of the masses. Anyway, along with that, India is also an abode of stories. 1.2 billion stories with uncountable colors, emotions, myths, traditions, culture, etc. Some of the best documentaries about India, which you may or may not have seen, have been things like The World Before Her, Inside the Mahakum, India Untouched, Bollywood, The Greatest Love Story Ever Told, Born into Brothels, Children on the Pyre, Gulabi Gang, Smile Pinky, Superman of Maligaon, and of course, the highly controversial Ram Ke Naam and Final Solution. Now, we started seeing documentaries that were depicting truth in an enhanced and stylized way. And what I think was going on was the human eye was changing. The way people could see reality as it mediated on a screen was transforming in a way that was actually quite fantastic. And it was entertaining and truthful at the same time. When documentaries can use the technology and skills that we normally associate with artists, with the ability to craft narratives and shoot cinematically compelling images, and use those skills in real life settings to tell important real life stories, then we've entered a highly evolved realm. And that's where we are at with docs these days, with filmmakers creating non-fiction works that are entertaining because they are both diverting and engaging. I personally have always admired non-fiction filmmaking. It's an absolute raw with naked emotions and a vulnerable story narrated as it is. And thankfully, with the burgeoning and unrestricted world of the internet and platforms like YouTube and Amazon and Netflix, the bottleneck has opened out into a vast ocean of limitless possibilities. So here's to the future of documentaries, and if you haven't watched any, you should start watching them. I think it's a great world to that's why, like Sophie mentioned, IDF, Sophie, we collaborated, and I hope that we can take this much further and do our little bit to see that this extremely important medium. A lot of people, they go at the two opposite ends. Some look down at so-called commercial cinema. The commercial cinema looks down at the documentary filmmaker saying boring. But I think aaj ek zamana aisa aa gaya hai jab iska mishran hona bahut possible ho gaya hai, and the narrative style has changed, jaisa maine thodi der pehle kaha. So I think they're both interdependent. Raju, of course, has always made cinema without so-called what we call lecturing, and he has said what he wanted to say. Nandita has made films very strongly about what she believed in. Naseeba has been part of projects and films which have always brought about social change and had such an impact, whether it's women's rights, whether it's social, economical problems. Rahul has made films again for Zania. He's made Lamha, which also dealt with issues which are very, very volatile and which needed thinking into. So I think the people who are on stage, I couldn't find better personalities to represent the thought what IDF is trying to say, that we need to tell stories which can make an impact while not being boring and entertaining at the same time. Thank you for being here, and I hope we can take this further. Thank you.
Thank you, Javed. I hope there are some ideas and questions in the room. We'll come to those later, but will Javed first moderate a small session with our guests today? I will pass the mics on. Hang on.
Can we have the mic on? Okay. Can you put it a bit louder?
Yeah.
Got it? Can you hear me, guys? Okay. Okay, so first and foremost, जैसे मैंने कहा कि मैं बेहद शुक्रगुजार हूँ कि ये मेरे दोस्त, मेरे बड़े भाई, सब जो लोग हैं जो बहुत इस हमारे माध्यम के जरिए बहुत कुछ करते हैं अपने अपने रोल्स में. नंदिता जैसे कहा एक्टर भी हैं, डायरेक्टर भी हैं, भाई भी एक्टर तो बहुत जानते हैं, डायरेक्शन में भी थिएटर करते हैं, राजू की फिल्में देखी हैं, एडवर्टाइजिंग तालुक कर सकते हैं, राहुल has been involved with advertising, documentaries, Parzania jaisi film which require immense research. So why I think it's important for them to speak about today is they have put their money where their mouth is, and their actions and their time and their effort. So let me start, Naseer bhai, in your journey of 40 plus years with cinema, working with people like Shyam Benegal sir, Govind Nihalani, and so many different filmmakers from across the country, how do you feel documentaries need to be treated today, especially in India, and where do you see them going?
First of all, they should be made. There ought to be more filmmakers making documentaries out of choice. And that is the wonderful thing that seems to be happening now.
Sir, we can't really hear you, sir. Awaaz nahi aa rahi
hai. The mic ka volume bada hai. इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कम, हम लोग बिल भर देंगे.
हाँ, सुनाई दे रहा? कैन यू हियर मी नाउ?
यस सर,
यस सर.
देयर आरंट इनफ पीपल मेकिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज आउट ऑफ चॉइस इज व्हाट आई सेड, एंड देयर वरंट, बट द वंडरफुल डेवलपमेंट दैट सीम्स टू बी अकरिंग नाउ इज दैट देयर आर. व्हेन आई वाज अ चाइल्ड एंड इवन आफ्टर दैट देयर वाज दिस terrifying thing called the Films Division documentary that started before any movie, and people went into the hall late in order to avoid seeing the Films Division documentary. So I think Films Division has probably done more harm to the cause of documentaries than good. The fact that they have 10 godowns full of old documentaries is another matter. Very few of those were worth watching, and they gave documentary films a bad name. Then My understanding of the importance of documentaries began when I went to the FTII and saw the great documentaries made by people like Bert Hanstra and Agnieszka Hollander and so on, some by Manikol and some by Shyam Benegal as well. And I have always had a question mark in my mind about the kind of social change that can be brought about by cinema, to tell you the truth, though I've been part of so many so-called films which have attempted that. But what has never been a question mark in my mind is the importance of documentary cinema. And I really feel that if any cinema can bring about change, it is documentaries. And that is why I am very happy and privileged to be here today. And I congratulate Javed and Sophie for this initiative that they have taken to encourage documentary filmmaking, and to pass on the message that you सिर्फ मजबूरी की वजह से ही डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज नहीं बनानी चाहिए. यू हैव टू मेक डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज on subjects which matter, which you feel matter to you. And in general, I think that seems to be happening in the field of filmmaking, small filmmaking, and experimental playwriting as well these days.
Nasirbhai, actually, what you mentioned about change, I may kind of differ, because Raju made a film called Three Idiots, which actually brought about a change in policies and educational systems and how people were. So Raju, did you consciously attempt it, keeping that in mind that this is a subject I want to talk about, and it kind of personally, were you personally involved with something which impacted you that you felt I have to say this in my film?
I don't think anybody does think consciously ki main aisa karunga to ye ho jayega. Then you'll be fake. Actually, in the journey of writing a film, see, actually there's a difference. When you're making a fiction film, your prime thing in your head is that you want to entertain people. You might not sell your soul for it, but you still want to entertain them. But while in the journey of writing it, whatever life you've lived, whatever you've experienced, a part of it actually comes into, or something which you want to say kind of comes into it. You're also picking up from life, from your experiences when you're writing it. So we never started like that, but in the journey of writing somewhere, whatever we believe education should be like kind of seeped in. And I've always felt that you should say something with the film. But I'm not against people who are saying ki nahi film to sirf internet ke niche. It's okay, everybody's doing it. There's no moral, you know, judgment over. All kinds of cinema should be made, all kinds of things should be made. So while we are writing, I think whatever we want to say or whatever we will, somewhere I think deep down we all are activists actually. Kuch bolna chahte hain, to wo apne kaam mein bol dete hain. So in that journey, aisa hua. It's not because bahut major attempt tha aisa karne ko. Aur kai baar, if it's coming with some kind of honesty, it finds some resonance with people, they can find identification with it, and it can cause some change. It's not really going to change the world. होता है कुछ लोगों को फर्क पड़ेगा शायद, और मैं ऐसा मुझे उसके बाद भी कई लोग मिले, उन्होंने एक में तुम जाके गाली भी दी, उन्होंने कहा ये क्या है आप बोलते हो कॉलेज में, कॉलेज में कुछ नहीं होता यार. तो ऑल काइंड्स, बट ऑल आई एम सेइंग इज डॉक्यूमेंट्स इज एक्चुअली एन अमेजिंग वर्ड. Like how you written in books. Actually, I can't read fiction anymore. For the last 10-15 years, I've not read one fiction book. I read only non-fiction. In fact, somebody told me non-fiction sells more than fiction in books, apparently. I don't know whether it's right or wrong, but that's what I heard. Unfortunately, because we didn't have platforms, documentaries never reached people. People didn't know where to see it. People made it. There were some great documentaries. And as Mrs. Isa said, you know, some of them are so boring that you got, kind of got put off and you said, I have a documentary dekhni. But some people have made so engaging documentaries. But not only they're causing social change, they are informative. Even information is great. When you look at what David Attenborough did with Planet Earth, you say, wow, this is our planet. Or Michael Moore does with his documentaries. The moment he makes a documentary, first thing I want to see. He does it very dramatically, in a very engaging way. He's eventually saying something, but in a very engaging way. So now, since the world has opened up for documentaries, I think more people would come forward and make films which are engaging. You use the right word. Engaging is the word. You need to engage them, give them a new thought. The moment you give them a new thought, people are wanting to grab that. So thank you so much, actually, Sophie and Javed, for opening up the world of documentaries for this country. And I hope more and more people go and make films.
Absolutely. Thank you, Raju. Nandita, Firaq was something which you were very passionate about, and you have always, in some way or the other, whether it is AIDS awareness, violence against women, DOC, the campaign you very vociferous about, you think, like, again, I mean, obviously you've not been directly associated with a documentary platform as such, but since you spoke to me and you said that there is a need today to tell these stories, so what is your take as a filmmaker, more as a filmmaker than as an actor, on surrounding what's happening?
Well, I mean, I do think that films make an impact, even fiction. I know Nasir and I have had this conversation many a times before as well. Of course, it doesn't bring out any revolution. Is not my point. It so subliminally goes into our subconscious that we are not even aware, the good and the bad. And that's why I think whatever you and I are, we are also a product of what we read, the cinema we watch, the people we meet. Everything gets stored, and as we grow older, I think when, if our responses change, it's because of all these influences. It's so intangible, it's almost difficult to measure. And yet we know that these things impact us. And I think the way to find a proof of it is that why do the orthodox, the conservatives, the right wings, why do they want to ban a film? If it's just a 2-hour film, they should just ignore it. But they understand the power of cinema, they understand that what it's trying to say. And that's why they want to ban a book, they want to, you know, ban a film, they want to physically stop people from watching. And I personally have gone through it with fire and then again water, where they attacked it, because they do feel threatened. So I think it cinema can be used for social change. It doesn't have to be lecturing, for sure, not preachy, not high-handed, not like, listen, I'm telling you something good. None of us want to be told that. So I think that kind of cinema is just boring, and you know, that's what a lot of the FD films, like Naseer was saying, that has done probably more harm, because it was too preachy in its content. And I think we have an unconscious bias against documentaries. We've always somewhere thought it's going to be boring and it's not going to be interesting and fiction's going to spice it all up. But now that thing is changing, and documentaries have primarily suffered because of lack of distribution. I mean, it's almost like when you don't know something, you have a certain idea of it and you keep perpetuating that idea. Those of us who have actually seen interesting documentaries feel that it's a fascinating medium. Whether you're talking about Michael Moore's film or you just reminded me that Mariam Chandy had done Rat Catcher, which was an amazing film that we all saw, you know, world before her. There was a film called Fire in the Blood about the AIDS thing. I mean, living in Delhi, actually, I saw a lot more documentaries.
Is a
very powerful film.
Patenting of
life-saving films for HIV/AIDS and the nexus between pharmaceutical companies and corporates. In fact, in times where investigative journalism is actually decreasing, where we are now talking about alternate facts and post-truth, some strange terms are coming up, we don't know what is real, what is not real. In fact, we need more investigative documentaries because they go deeper into it. It requires a lot of time. You're not going to waste so much of time to bring out falseness. You know, it's actually a journey of finding the truth of something. So therefore, in our times, the times we are living in, when we don't know what is really true, what is false, are we reading the right things, are we watching the right channels, the importance of documentaries, in fact, has increased. Because today we need more nuanced understanding of things. It's not about for and against, something that will deeply explore a particular subject. And India being such a wide, you know, there are so many stories, such a huge country with so much diversity. Like this Khabar Lehriya, what you talked about, I remember releasing one of their reports, and it's a fantastic initiative where women who have not been trained in journalism are doing in UP, in a small little district, women who have been housewives and just doing work at home have suddenly now gotten out, they are journalists, they are printing their own paper, they are going and distributing. So these kind of incredible stories actually would be very exciting, and we have to find ways to distribute. I was just in Calcutta yesterday. There's a documentary on Amartya Sen that has been made called An Argumentative Indian. And all of us know a certain side of Amartya Sen, but wouldn't we want to know more? What makes him the economist, the philosopher? What are his thoughts about different things? And Shumon Ghosh, the director, is struggling to find distribution in Delhi and Bombay. So I think together, if we create that kind of a climate where documentaries is seen differently and we find platforms to show it, would be great. I mean, there are hardly any that are actually released. So much power is needed today to release, because the marketing platforms remain the same. So many of the documentaries that I saw in my growing up years were not for release. They were like in small private screenings in special auditoriums. So I think the media would play such a big role in creating that kind of an awareness. So absolutely. Thanks, Javed.
I think it's sure. Too much to hope for. That someday documentaries will show in theaters and people will
flock
to see them. I don't know if that will happen. But I think the importance of documentaries is for the sake of posterity. You may just find that the idealism with which you've gone into it being a little shaken by the fate that the documentaries meet. Because it's, I think it is too much to hope for that people will actually buy tickets to go and see en masse.
But I don't think that if, okay, I understand. But if you look today in England, there are at least 15% or 20% cinema screens which actually keep screening documentaries and people actually go and watch them. It's just following the audience to.
Yeah, yeah, sure. I'm not knocking your effort. There are also in England about 500 theatres which are full every night. So I don't think we can quite equate, you know. But no, I'm just being the devil's advocate, that is all.
But on Netflix, I believe documentaries are in fact more sought after. Because people don't get to see documentaries on Netflix, I've been told that they are the most sought after are the documentaries.
Right.
So I think that is the effort, that how do we popularize?
Like Nasir Bhai, what you said, the mediums have changed and they are very radical because today in my pocket, in my phone, and I can access because of like platforms like Netflix and Amazon. Theatres, distributors, nahi milenge, fair enough. But at least I have a medium today, sort of, I can have access to so many documentaries, I just subscribe. So hopefully, now what we need to do is like the media supporting and encouraging and
audio.
Okay. You also made, I think, two documentaries. Teenage parents. ये जो आपका इस ये साइड हमने देखा नहीं था. Recently I came to know कि आप you had made kind of documentaries on that.
I started off with documentaries actually.
Yeah.
I started off with documentaries, did the documentary. I worked as a production assistant or a producer for documentaries for Channel 4. So they were
on various subjects from Sindhi Jews and Black Muslims,
audio.
The opposition uniting before the Rajiv Gandhi, before VP Singh came to power, on Kashmir, on AIDS, all kinds of stuff.
And in America, I did three documentaries on hate crimes, Asian Indians. First, Teenage Parents, which was about teenagers. And also on a Pakistani taxi driver in New York City. So, and both three or two of these won some awards over there. So it was, I started off with that. And I think it's, I'm going to come back to that now. As far as, because in today's times, there's so many stories you want to say, and you start censoring yourself. When it the thought comes in, Manani, we not happen, that will happen. Like we were just discussing, can we make a Prasanian now? You know, it will, and I'd rather make documentaries then. Because I can be fearless, I can fearlessly say what I want to say, and I don't need it to get censored or any such thing to air it, which I always had a problem with. So I think it's great time. Also, people can make documentaries more easily now than before. It's because of the digital world which we are in. You can make, you can say, tell your stories, so many stories. And we have platforms now. So it's a great initiative both of you have done, and I'm glad.
Yeah. Well, we hope these documentaries take, and I think media support is very important, that you all give that space and a little bit of time and encouragement to these filmmakers who spend sometimes years in researching, taking risks to their lives, going into territories which actually really big, people have actually been threatened and sometimes been beaten up, some of the documentary filmmakers, but they have managed to bring about policy changes. There was a film called A Pestering Journey about the effect of pesticides on the farmers and the families. It was huge. It was totally devastating to see kids with these huge heads. It was called a cancer train. Every day it's to come. And that actually brought about some changes in quality control of pesticides, GMOs, etc. So I think this is a good movement. We are just catalysts, and I hope that y'all can be part of it too. And if y'all have anything to ask any of these revered, wonderful guests of ours, I'll open it to you guys for a bit, and then we can take it from there.
Raju sir,
Raju sir, do you think instead of making a commercial film with Ranbir Kapoor, had you made a simple documentary on Sanjay Dutt's life, would it have attracted enough buzz in the market?
See, certain subjects will be more engaging if they are done in a fiction format. And certain subjects would be able to probably say more in a documentary format. Like, what I want to do, actually, I'll tell you. I had met PK, and PK was the only film actually which started the reverse, as Javed was saying, where I wanted to talk about God and religion. But in the journey of making that film, I ended up realizing that I ended up talking very little about it. There's so much to talk about God and religion that you cannot actually, in a fictional film format, say how much you want to say. Because in a fiction format, you are expected that you have to sugarcoat your story, entertain them, and still manage to say what you want to say. So at some stage, I do want to make a documentary. I think I've said a lot of unsaid things. There are lots unsaid in PK. So I want to do a documentary where you can bang on straight face, say what you want to say. But in a film like Sanju, I think it's more engaging as a fictional film where you see another actor doing it. If you were to simply pick up a mic and say, okay, here's a man who did drugs, who had a gun, who did this thing, it's boring.
So, but interestingly, there was a documentary made on Sanjay's life, From Hell and Hell to Back or something of that
sort. But maybe this will be more interesting.
No, maybe, but with your perspective, you could have done something different. And my point is, maybe a documentary from your end on Sanjay's life would have probably been much better than BBC's documentary.
No, I feel biopics are more interesting when you see it in a fictional format.
Okay.
Otherwise, they get boring. Subjects where you want to say something else, where there are no characters. Like, as I said, if I have to talk about God, I will probably do it. Not a biopic, a documentary.
Also, if I may answer on Raju's behalf, in order to make a documentary on Sanjay, you would have had to have footage of him right from the day he was born and when he went to school,
exactly.
And etc. and etc. So, if it would be a so-called documentary, because he'd have to recreate, it would be a fictionalized documentary.
Docudrama.
Now, you actually mentioned that you were talking to Nandita if a Firaq and a Farzaniya can be made today. I was really curious, considering the times that we are living in, when people are really touching, and I think both of your films had to face severe problems, especially in Gujarat. Can the films be made today?
I think even Jaane Bhi Toh Yaaron you can't make today. And I'm not joking. I'm not joking.
Alright, I think I'll make it as a documentary again, because you can't make it as a feature film. It's tough. It was tough then. It was very tough releasing the film, censoring that, and that was 2005-6. We had problems even releasing the films. So till today we face problems because of that. And considering the way everyone is so sensitive to everything, it's almost impossible to tell something and people take it in the right way. You know, because the whole purpose is not, like for example, people forget about it. Like if you make something today, they'll either, like even that time they said, I remember in IFFI when we screened the film, they said the film is made with Dowd's money. So, if in 2005 they were talking, look at today's times. Padmavati you cannot make then. It's a question of Farzaniya.
First of all, I don't think things have to be this or that. There is a place for fiction, there's a place for short film, there's a place for documentary. All of this can exist and should exist. The point is that all the rest exists, this hasn't found its space. So when we are here championing the cause of documentaries, it's not for or against, you know, fiction film, like in books. So you have fiction stories, you have non-fiction, you have short stories, and all of them should exist. When a place for a particular genre starts shrinking, and you feel that, what about those stories? So, I mean, like Fire was made, and it was about homosexuality. In fact, it's one film that I feel had a more tangible impact. Since in the last 20 years, if there is more conversation about LGBT, if 377 is being questioned, was repealed by the Delhi High Court, somewhere I think Fire did sow the seed of that. The fact that it brought that whole subject in the public domain, it triggered certain questions about it. And there have been made, there are documentaries on LGBT issues. So this is such a vast area that I hope that we won't oversimplify it and say whether this should be fiction. Both will have its own impact and have its own, like Naseeb was saying, there are some films that need to be for posterity, all films are actually now for posterity. But we want to see a more in-depth story and, you know, something that would maybe cover various issues of LGBT, and yet we want to be moved by a particular story and take from it what we, each of us will take different things. So it's not an either-or situation, how I see.
Yeah, Erin Brockovich was a good example of how a film made an impact and changes in policies. Yeah. Okay, so I think we've covered anything else.
So different short film
and definition.
Short films are short. Documentaries can be short or long. I think a different format. When you say short films, long films are formats, documentaries can be short, long. Short films can be fiction, can be documentaries.
Okay. Thank you for that interesting question. Okay. Okay. Okay, I think one more.
These films are in production, so when they get completed, it's up to the director which platform they want to give it.
In fact, by the audience a little bit about the process and the film, so that there's some more clarity on the process of documentary filmmaking.
Hello. I have been following this family from last 2 years, and it has been a very interesting journey. And as she asked, like, which platforms? Of course, we would like to distribute in theaters, but it's very difficult in India. And Netflix and Amazon, like, are coming into the market. It's easy for filmmakers like us to show our documentary there.
Thank you. See, like I said, IDF is a catalyst. It's giving a platform, and we're opening it out to people who will be from various fields, like you said. So when they make the pitch, there's a table of eight. So 8 × 4 is 32 people who will, in their own way, show us avenues where they can take these films and take it to the next step. So 250 over, 32 on the panel. Okay, so first and foremost, thank you.
Jagat, can I just say one small thing? There have been fiction filmmakers like Satyajit Ray, K. Abbas, and many others who have also made documentaries. I don't think it's so straight-jacketed that if you're a documentary filmmaker, you can't make fiction, or fiction filmmakers can't. So I think that fluidity also we have somewhere lost. And, you know, a lot of the documentary filmmakers, are, at least in Delhi, the ones I saw, very serious documentary filmmaker. They have nothing to do with fiction. The fiction filmmakers have nothing to do with documentaries. With digital medium and with, you know, these cameras being so small and people being more open to these ideas, I think fiction filmmakers could also make
I think we have one here, like we make 12 documentaries, they make 3-4
Yeah, but it's less and less. I'm saying in general, it's not as fluid as it could be.
So thank you, Naseeb Bhai, you, Nandita, Rahul, and thank you for your support, and thank you for spending your time with us. And I'd like to pass on the baton to all of you who are here to take forth the Film for Change movement and kickstarting the social campaign at Good Pitch India, which is on the 4th of April in NCPA. So if you all come and be a part of that, it would be wonderful, and help us take this step ahead. It is a responsibility, a social responsibility of us as being part of this country. So we are filmmakers, we use a medium, you are the media, you have a medium. So if you can join forces and take this step ahead and encourage documentaries in the right sense, and let them see, take shape better, and the awareness and developing a taste in the audience and wiping out their slate, like Nasiba said, film divisions ka wo slate ko mitana padega ki nahi. Documentaries also are interesting and engaging. Thank you very much, and God bless. Jai Hind. Thank you.
Before we disperse, one group photo with all our guests. Yeah, Sophie, could you please join them? Vaibhav, please join the group.